Blood circulatory system in fishes. In this lecture we shall learn general scheme of circulatory system in bony fishes, details of sharks or chondrichthyes circulatory system, and finally the most important, lung fishes. Stay connected. Well, this is the general schematic diagram of circulatory system of bony fish. Major components of circulatory system are sinus venosus, which collect deoxygenated blood from all parts of body. The next chamber is atrium, which receive blood from sinus and when filled push the blood to next chamber. The next chamber is ventricle, which is also called heart of fishes. Ventricle then pushes blood to next chamber, which is conus arteriosus or bulbous arteriosus in some fishes. These four chambers are the main structures in fish circulatory system. Next to conus is ventral aorta, which supply blood to respiratory capillaries for oxygenation in gills. After oxygenation, the blood is directly sent to dorsal aorta for distribution to body parts, and exchange of materials occurs in systemic capillaries in general. When blood becomes deoxygenated, it is collected by veins from whole body and is again sent to sinus venosus. Now you have observed that the circulation has single loop or pathway, that's why such circulation is termed as single circuit circulation. Now basic idea behind circulation is clear, and you may be asked questions like, which type of blood circulates through heart of fishes? Which aorta has deoxygenated blood? In which chamber the deoxygenated blood is collected first? And to which part of body ventricle of fish pumps blood, etc., etc. Let's explore the circulation in some more detail in sharks, which belong to chondrichthyes. In this diagram, please note that dark tubes are veins and little lighter ones are arteries. We know that veins collect deoxygenated blood from all parts of body after exchange of materials in capillaries. These veins supply blood to sinus venosus in all fishes. Sinus venosus has valves which open when it is filled and stop the backflow of blood. When sinus is filled, blood enters into atrium, which is a pump, and pushes the blood to next chamber, the ventricle. When ventricle contracts, it forces the blood toward conus arteriosus, which is comparatively small in sharks. Now it's time to understand the oxygenation process. From conus arteriosus, deoxygenated blood enters ventral aorta and is pushed toward gills. We know that there are five pairs of gill slits in fishes from evolutionary point of view. These gills are provided with extensive network of capillaries for gaseous exchange. When blood enters these capillaries, carbon dioxide diffuses out from the blood and oxygen diffuses in the blood due to gradients or concentration differences. When blood becomes oxygenated, that is rich in oxygen, it then sent to aortic arches which join dorsal aorta. Dorsal aorta, as the name suggests, lies dorsal side or toward vertebral column. Dorsal aorta then supplies blood to all parts of body with the help of respective arteries. For example, celiac arteries supply blood to stomach, esophagus, etc. Genital arteries to gonads or sex organs. Renal arteries to kidneys. Subclavian arteries to fore fins. And iliac arteries to hind fins. After passing from systemic capillaries, the blood becomes deoxygenated, and then veins again collect it and send to sinus venosus, and the cycle begins again. Hope the cycle is clear now. Blood moves in one circuit, so it's single circuit circulation. That's for shark or chondrichthyes. Hope the circulation is clear. In case of any confusion or further queries, please comment on. I know you are anxious and enthusiastic about lung fishes circulation, so let's move to lung fishes. Please pay attention to both audio and video. Lung fish circulation is little bit more complicated than typical fishes. Sinus venosus is same like other fishes and collect deoxygenated blood from whole body, but neck structure needs your special attention to understand. The atrium is modified in lung fishes and is different from other fishes. In the diagram, you can notice a small septum hanging in atrium, which is called pulmonalis fold or interatrial septum. This septum separates oxygenated blood coming from lungs and deoxygenated blood coming from sinus venosus. Although it's not complete separation, but still it helps to keep both types away from mixing because the flow is quick and little time is allowed. That's why the mixing is little. When both oxygenated and deoxygenated bloods enter ventricle, it quickly pumps them into folds of arteriosus. Arteriosus folds supply oxygenated and deoxygenated blood to different tubes. Folding in arteriosus plays the vital role here. Deoxygenated blood is sent toward last two gill arches. Please note the diagram. Now, there are two conditions. If the fish is respiring through gills, then this blood becomes oxygenated while passing through gills and is sent to lungs, through which it just passes toward atrium and no change occurs because lungs are not supplied with the air. In second condition, if fish is respiring through lungs only, then this deoxygenated blood passes through gills as it is and then reaches lungs where oxygenation occurs. Hope you got the basic concept. And in some fishes, both gills and lungs may work together at the same time. From lungs, the oxygenated blood enters atrium. This is one type of pathway or one circuit. The oxygenated blood from arteriosus is supplied to two middle arches which do not have any gills, please note, and blood passes directly to dorsal aorta for supply. First two gill arches have same function as in other fishes of gills. So in summary, the gill slits numbers 1st, 2nd, 5th and 6th have gills, but 3rd and 4th do not have gills. That is adaptation toward land habitats. After entering dorsal aorta, the next procedure is same as discussed earlier. Now try to understand double circuit circulation in lung fishes. One circuit completes when deoxygenated blood from sinus venosus move to lungs and come back to sinus after oxygenation. That is called pulmonary circulation. Second circuit completes when oxygenated blood from sinus venosus move to body parts through dorsal aorta and return to sinus venosus after deoxygenation. This circulation is called systemic circulation. So, in lung fishes, there is double circuit circulation, which is unique to other fishes and a step ahead toward land habitats. Hope you have understood all aspects in mind. In case you have any query or confusion, you can comment and discuss with me. Now, if I ask some questions, would you answer them? Yes? Okay. What is pulmonalis fold and what is its function? Please write the answer in comments. Lung fishes have only lungs or both lungs and gills? How many gill arches are present in lung fishes unlike other fishes? Please write the answers of all these questions in the comment so that your concept may be cleared further. Thanks for staying with me